I'm the salvation of the people, says the Lord. Should they cry to me in any distress, I will hear them. I will be their Lord forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Your Son to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and our neighbor, grant that we, by keeping your precepts, may merit to attain eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Reading from the book of Proverbs. The king's heart is a stream of water in the hand of the Lord. He turns it wherever he will. All these are right in the sight of the doer, but the Lord weighs the heart. To do righteousness and justice is more acceptable to the Lord than sacrifice. Haughty eyes and proud heart, the lamp of the wicked, are sin. The plans of diligent lead surely to abundance, but everyone who is hasty comes only to want. The getting of treasures by a lying tongue is a fleeting vapor and a snare of death. The souls of the wicked desire evil. Their neighbors find no mercy in their eyes. When a scoffer is punished, the simple become wiser. When the wise are instructed, they increase in knowledge. The righteous one observes the house of the wicked. He casts the wicked down to ruin. If you close your ear to the cry of the poor, you will cry out and not be heard. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The response is, guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands.
Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands.
Happy are those whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord. Make me understand the way of your precepts, and I will meditate on your wondrous works. Response. Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands. I have chosen the way of faithfulness. I set ordinances before me. Give me understanding that I may keep your law and observe it with my whole heart. Response. Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands. Lead me in the path of your commandments, for I delight in it. I will keep your law continually, forever and ever. Response. Guide me, Lord, in the way of your commands.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus' mother and his brothers came to him, but they could not reach him because of the crowd, and he was told, your mother and your brothers are standing outside wanting to see you. But Jesus said to them, my mother and my brothers are those who hear the word of God and do it. The Gospel of the Lord. God is always looking for the family resemblance in our lives. And that's what he's ultimately asking for, that you and I desire today to do God's will, to seek God's will and then to do it. And that's how we show ourselves related to God. We might be related, you know, through the Eucharist, through our baptism, but God wants us to make manifest our connection to Him by seeking the will of God today and by doing it. What is the will of God today? Well, the will of God is that you and I become holy. You and I choose to sacrifice. We choose to love. We choose to use the grace to perfect our lives today. We choose to do everything for the merit and glory of God. That's what it looks like to do God's will today. And we can ask God, God, help me to seek your will today. We come here today. The ultimate act of doing God's will is the Holy Eucharist, where Jesus lays down his life for us so that we could have the Eucharist. He saves us. So the Eucharist gives us the strength to do the will of God today. We'll be tempted in many different ways to do something selfish, to do something prideful, any one of the deadly sins. We'll be tempted to do that today. And God is strengthening you and I to follow his holy will, to desire what is good and holy, and to do all for the glory of God. Dear brothers and sisters, gathered as one to celebrate the good things we've received from our God, let us ask him to prompt in us prayers that are worthy of his hearing. We pray for our Holy Father Francis, for Pope Emeritus Benedict, for our Bishop Joseph, for their health, intentions, and constant growth in faith, hope, and charity. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for the grace to hear the will of God today and to do it, to use the grace that is given to us, especially in this Holy Eucharist, that our lives may be perfected and image the great love of God. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for unity in our Christian community, that we may image God's love among us. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for all those who have asked us to pray for them. We pray for an end to the coronavirus, moral end to it. We pray for peace in the world, especially in the United States. We pray to a return to the truth and the goodness of God's plan for the world. For this we pray to the Lord. We offer up this Mass for a special intention. For this we pray to the Lord. And if you have any prayers and intentions, you may offer them up now. The Lord. We pray for all the holy souls in purgatory, and we ask them to join us with the saints and angels in heaven, especially Saint Joseph, our Blessed Mother, Saint Ignatius, to pray for more vocations to the priesthood, to the consecrated life, and to holy matrimony, to preserve all those in their vocations, and assist us in our universal call to holiness. For this we pray to the Lord. May the petitions of your church be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, so that we may receive from your mercy what we cannot ask out of confidence in our own merit. Through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, root of the earth and work of human hands, that will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praise adds nothing to your greatness, but profits us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Joseph our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, of the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, who may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul, since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally. Come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep, and mine know me. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with the sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended.